shines with hope and grace, fills the sky with new mercy.
Be washed away, Our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts,
as we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom,
the power,
and the glory,
forever and ever.
Amen.
My family didn't really eat out a lot when I was growing up. But Sundays were special. Every few weeks, we'd go to this pancake place that was right across the street from our church. And no matter what I ordered, I always ordered orange juice. Because I loved orange juice. But it always came in the smallest glass. And doesn't it seem like most of the good stuff is like that? Limited. I think about that every autumn. Each fall, there's this perfect moment when the air is crisp and the colors are just crazy, but blink and you'll miss it. And after that, it is cold and wet and gray. Before you know it, it's snowing. Are my kids. One minute they're climbing into my lap and they want to cuddle and they're saying aminal instead of animal. And then all of a sudden they got it figured out. And it feels like you can just watch this moment slip away. There were never free refills on orange juice. So I'd work so hard to make it last. I would limit myself and I'd just take the tiniest sips to try to make it last across the whole meal. Because there weren't any free refills and it wasn't going to be in the refrigerator at home and I never knew when I'd get my next glass. And I worry that I live my whole life like that. Afraid that everything good is about to be gone. As if God has set some tiny glass in front of me and he said, that's it. That's all the good I have for you, for your whole life. So I hope you can make it last. And so I hold myself back from the good things. I'm afraid to really drink them in. I limit myself to the tiniest sips. But is that who God really is? Every so often, my son in particular, he gets his heart set on something, some gift that, whether it's for Christmas or his birthday, a gift that just outshines them all. And I love being the one to give it to him. But I wonder what I would feel if he then put it on a shelf and he was afraid to touch it, afraid to use it, afraid to enjoy it. I think that would be so heartbreaking. Because I want him to enjoy it. I want to see him enjoy it. That's part of why I gave it to him. But what would be even more heartbreaking is what his fear tells me he believes about my generosity. That he probably better be careful because there may not be more where that came from. I think it has to break God's heart when we hold ourselves back from really enjoying the good things he puts in our lives. I think we have a choice when we receive good things from God. We have a choice to trust. To trust in a good God. A God who says, I have so much good for you. For your whole life. So don't be afraid. Enjoy it.
Holy, 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 holy. see you.
Hi. In the busyness of everyday life, we often find ourselves caught up in schedules, responsibilities, endless tasks. And as you watch this, I am actually away on study leave and on holiday. Amidst all the noise, God invites us to take time out, to step away from the rush and seek his presence. God gives us the invitation to rest. It was Jesus who said in Matthew 11 and verse 28, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." See, our souls crave rest, not just physical rest, but really soul rest, a quiet communion with our Creator. To enjoy stillness, to enjoy solitude. You know, Jesus so often would withdraw to solitary places and he would stop and he would pray. We read that in Luke chapter 5 and verse 16. And we too need those moments of stillness, to have solitude, to find God whisper to us his gentle guidance, the reassurance that we are loved beyond measure by him. Going away gives us that time to reflect on his word. Taking time out to involve opening our Bible and reading Bible passages and allowing those truths to sink deep into us. You know the words of Psalm 46, which says, "Be still and know that I am God." Or Psalm 119, where it says, "In the quiet, his word becomes a lamp to our feet and a light to our path." It gives time to allow gratitude and surrender to him. As we pause, we can express the gratitude for the blessings that he gives to us. We've been thinking about blessings over the last few weeks. To surrender our worries to him. When we say, "Lord, I want to stop. I want to let you know how grateful I am. You provide for me. You are providing me for me. And I declare now that I will put my trust in you for all of my needs in the coming days." We can also find rest as we go into nature's cathedral. Especially at this time of year, we can go out and we can walk into the countryside. And I would encourage you to do that. Take time out literally. Whether it's a walk in the park, a walk in the woods, to hear the sound of streams, to hear waves on a beach, to hear the rustling of the leaves. It's so beautiful to go out and do those things. And I hope to do those things while I am away. We can be wowed by the beauty of creation around us. Beauty that we don't always notice when we're rushing around doing things, but when we stop and take time out, we can really notice those things around us. And we can have prayerful moments with our Creator. You know, prayer is this conversation that we can have with our Heavenly Father. And so take time to pour out your heart over this holiday season. Listen and receive his peace. In Philippians 4 and verses 6 to 7, it assures us that his peace surpasses all our understanding. The Bible talks about a Sabbath rest, a time to stop. You know, we humans are not designed to just keep working 7 days a week. It takes its toll on us. And God has instituted this Sabbath, this take time to just be quiet, to be with him. Our Heavenly Father says, rest. It's okay to take time out. It's okay to rest. In fact, he would instruct us to do that. So may you take time out. A moment of quiet where your soul meets with the divine and you rest in him.
I'm me now.
And I pray, Lord, that we may go from here wanting to share that good news, wanting to be that salt and that light to those around us. And Lord, may we align ourselves with Scripture this coming week. And Lord, we know that you have promised that every step that we take, every place that we go, you're going to be with us in our defeats and in our victories, in our bad times and in our good times. In our dark days and in our bright days, Lord, we can always, always, always count on the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.